السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. الله سبحانه وتعالى has sent down books upon his messengers to clarify his right and to call to it. And he said in the Quran, لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. Indeed, we have sent messengers with clear proofs and signs and sent down with them the scripture and the balance of justice so that people may maintain and uphold justice. And he subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كان الناس أمة واحدة فبعث الله النبيين مبشرين ومنذرين وأنزل معهم الكتاب بالحق ليحكم بين الناس فيما اختلفوا فيه. Mankind was one community, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent prophets with glad tidings and warning. And with them he sent the scripture in truth to judge between people in their disputes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent all books with a guidance and light that show people the right path. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the Torah, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَا التَّوْرَاةَ فِيهَا هُدًى وَنُورٌ يَحْكُمُ بِهَا النَّبِيُّونَ الَّذِينَ أَسْلَمُوا لِلَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالرَّبَّانِيُّونَ وَالْأَحْبَارُ بِمَا اسْتُحْفِظُوا مِنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ وَكَانُوا عَلَيْهِ شُهَدَاءَ. Indeed, we send down the Torah with guidance and light, by which the prophets who submitted themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to judge for the Jews, and so did the rabbis and scholars after those prophets, for to them was entrusted the protection of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they were witnesses thereto. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said concerning the Injil, the Gospel, وَقَفَّيْنَا عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ بِعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ التَّوْرَاةِ وَآتَيْنَاهُ الْإِنْجِيلَ فِيهِ هُدًى وَنُورٍ ومصدقا لما بين يديه من التوراة وهدى وموعظة للمتقين. And in their footsteps we sent Jesus, son of Mary, confirming the Torah that had come before him, and we give him the Injil, the Gospel, with guidance, light, and confirmation of the Torah that had come before it, a guidance and a lesson for those who have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran is the final and the best of all these books. It confirms and replaces the scripture that came before it, and it is a witness over them, confirming the truth and denying the falsehood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَمُهَيْمِنًا عَلَيْهِ. We have sent down to you, Muhammad, the scripture with the truth, confirming the scripture that came before it, and with final authority over them. There are many narrations from Ibn Abbas for the meaning of muhaymin. The first is ay mu'tamanan alayh. It means entrusted over it. Another meaning is al-muhaymin al-amin. فَالْقُرْآنُ أَمِينٌ عَلَى كُلِّ كِتَابٍ قَبْلَهُ. It means the trustworthy. The Quran is trustworthy over every divine book that came before it. Ibn Jarir rahimahullah said, Al-Quran aminun ala al-kutub al-mutaqaddima. Fama wafaqahu minha fahuwa haq, wama khalafahu minha fahuwa batil. The Quran is trustworthy over the books that came before it. Therefore, whatever in these previous books comply with the Quran is true, and whatever disagrees with the Quran is false. It was said that it means shahida, muhaiminan ay shahidan, which means witness. Another meaning is hakiman ala ma qablahu min al-kutub. It means controlling with final authority over the previous scriptures. And these meanings are similar or close to each other, as the word muhaimin includes them all. Thus, the Quran is trustworthy, a witness, and controlling over every scripture that came before it. There is a sound hadith from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, according to which he said, إِذَا حَدَّثَكُمْ أَهْلُ الْكِتَابِ فَلَا تُصَدِّقُوهُمْ وَلَا تُكَذِّبُوهُمْ. If the people of the book narrate something to you, then don't believe them and don't disbelieve them. And to understand this hadith, we need to know that the reports fall into three categories. Some of them have been confirmed by our revelation. So we know this is this to be true because of evidence to that from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some have been denied by our revelation. So we know this to be false because of evidence to the contrary from the Quran and sunnah. And for some of it, there is no evidence either way. It was neither confirmed nor denied by our revelation. And this is what permission has been given to narrate from the people of the book. And there is nothing wrong with narrating them. As the Prophet Muhammad said, حَدِّثُوا عَنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ وَلَا حَرَجْ. Narrate from the children of Israel and no problem. Ibn Kathir رحمه الله said, لكن هذا فيما قد يجوزه العقل فأما فيما تحيله العقول ويحكم عليه بالبطلان ويغلب على الظنون كذبه فليس من هذا القبيل. But that only applies to what is acceptable according to common sense. As for that which common sense would reject and deem to be false, or it is thought most likely that it is a lie, that doesn't come under this permission. However, there is no reason either to believe it or disbelieve it. So they shouldn't be believed or disbelieved, because the Prophet Muhammad said, فَلَا تُصَدِّقُوهُمْ وَلَا تُكَذِّبُوهُمْ. Then don't believe them and don't disbelieve them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the people of knowledge and understanding. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. وصل اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله. اللهم يمن كتابنا ويسر حسابنا. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك وأغننا بفضلك عمن سواك. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصل اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.